Can't Nazarene. Did I get the hair right? All right, just having a little fun there. But it's been great to celebrate with you this month, 100 years of ministry in Canton, Ohio. We started off week one just celebrating the different generations of our church and the value that each generation adds to our community of faith. Then the next week, we received communion together for the first time in a long time and talked about the importance of an outward focus. So that Sunday, we gathered, and then you took the gift cards and blessed people with those, and we filled up crisis care kits and packets for the homeless and blankets. Thank you for just reaching out and sharing the love of Jesus that month, picking up trash on 30th Street. Awesome, awesome. And then this last Sunday, the 100th celebration, David Lutz was here, shared a great message, just made us think about people in our lives that have touched us and then how we can be those people for others. Hearing from all the pastors from the past, just so encouraging. And then we want to wrap up this final Sunday in September with the most important thing, the gospel of Jesus Christ. And we're going to do it through something that I love called At the Movies, where we look at a movie. And this week we're going to look at The Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. This story was actually written by C.S. Lewis, who was raised in the church, confirmed in the church, baptized, and then left the faith, became an atheist, came back to God, and then God used him in a powerful way to write this story and many others that just powerfully communicate the gospel in a creative way. So looking forward to sharing that with you. Now, with At the Movies, we can't post that online because of copyright laws, so that'll only be available if you show up in person at 9 or 10:30. Again, we've taken every precaution for all people to be safe, but again, we understand if you still don't feel safe to come in person. We realize there's certain situations and conditions that will prevent that. But we're praying for you, love you, even though you won't be able to be with us this Sunday. So again, thank you for being such a great church. I love being your pastor. I love you. And we are made for more. God has more and more ministry for us to do this year and in the years to come. Well, remember this. God loves you. And so do I. Have a great, great week.